we all know that Europe is going through a crucial transitional period. The economic crisis has imposed the implementation of restrictive fiscal policies in order to safeguard the fiscal stability and consolidate the public finances. Of course, the extent of the crisis and the level of recession and unemployment, especially in some member states, have shaken the confidence of an important segment of European citizens to the EU. The big challenge for the European Union now is to reaffirm its mission at the hearts and minds of its citizens. It is obvious that promoting growth, employment and cohesion remains a top priority, as it was also during the Lithuanian presidency. And also the interim evaluation of the Europe 2020 strategy offers the opportunity for more concrete initiatives on growth and job creation. The second group of priorities concerns the deepening of the Union, especially the Economic and Monetary Union. A third group of priorities goes around migration, border management and mobility of Union citizens and European security, internal and external, to have a more coherent and more comprehensive European Union migration policy. A fourth horizontal priority concerns the maritime policies. The idea here is to have a more comprehensive approach to different aspects of maritime policies, which includes security, it includes maritime transport, it includes coastal tourism, enlargement policy, where the Lithuanian presidency did an excellent job. And let me also congratulate Serbia for this historic step that was decided yesterday. So enlargement overall and enlargement to the Western Balkans continues to be a top priority of the Greek presidency. Montenegro, as it was said, the negotiations are advancing. With Turkey, there was an opening of a chapter after a big period of inactivity. And we are very glad that also the negotiations with Serbia will start during our presidency. I think this will have a beneficial effect to the whole region and to all countries. We are limited by not only by human capacities, but also by the fact that for the legislation, we are going to have only 3.5 months. The last plenary session of the European Parliament will be mid-April. We have, of course, reinforced, as every presidency is doing, our permanent representation here, but to a much lesser extent than other presidencies, because we want also, for reasons of substance, but also for reasons of symbolism, have a very cost-efficient presidency.